Welcome to another episode of Pop the Hood. I'm your host, Imzan Ali, and today we are here at Maxxis Tire Center to feature none other than Brandon Rampersad, also known as QG Banter. Check it out. So Brandon, tell us a bit about what actually got you involved in motorsport and a bit more about yourself.
Well, before my passion started for cars, I started entering my dad at the age of 5. It's like, I'm pretty young, yeah. Small thing. I don't believe in myself. Yeah, so basically what I started to do MIG welding, and we have the exhaust shop. And along the years I become good up to the list and started to do high quality fabrication, etc.
So based on hearing what you just said there, what struck my attention was the fact that you said you started at 5 years. What really transcended that into the passion you have right now for what you do?
Well, my passion for welding started at the age of 5 because as growing up as a kid, my dad was always into motorsport, well not motorsports, but motorsport cars coming into the garage. And my dad upstairs came with his Indian song, it convinced me to go downstairs and work together with him and sort of that. And also, kind of moved to my grandparents' place, which is my uncle, also known as Suspects, Bobo. That was a big room for me, seeing type of different cars, models, everything. And by watching the engine bay, that was a big thing for me, you know, nice, all these things. I don't know nothing, but it catch my eyes there.
So we reached a point where I think the viewers would want to know a little bit more about this AD Wagon, hard bench, something like that. Tell us.
Well, to be honest, how I really acquired that Y11 AD Wagon, also known as the hard bench. I'll laugh there, right? Actually, I really wanted an 831 Altima. That was my dream car, it still is. So it doesn't really take the future role, maybe, my dad never one. But the Nissan Y11 AD was the family car. And my dad offered me that, hey, you can't afford the 831, or helped me at the time. So he gave me the opportunity where I could have the Y11 at full. So I take it up on myself. I was going to NASC and I used it to go back and forth home to NASC. Right, so after NASC days and completing my course, I did apply for the fabrication course. That is when you say I'm certified with welding certificate, nothing. Right. after that, I was full time in the garage with my dad running the shop. And the knowledge that I gained from NASC, it helped me a lot. Commented more into the motorsport kind of aspects. However, for the car yesterday in the casual condition, basically I catch a mad box and I scrap out the interior. I had no idea if I had money to paint the car, do the interior or anything. So I was like, I come on, hey, I'll paint the car. See, here, bring it, you come on, have more weekends. Nice. It took about 6 months. I like when I come out due to the time period. It was not a long, but we get through. Paint job will no more than man car than these days. 2 years. Yeah. No hard feelings.
Alright Brandon, so I think that's about enough talking where it comes to the car. Let's actually go and take a look and see what you can say more as far as this project is concerned. So Brandon, we are here with the Nissan Y11 AD. Tell us a bit about what's happening inside it.
So before we get started as to what we have inside here, I'll say all the fab work, fine details I put together by me.
Wow.
Right, so coming to the engine. Previously I had a QG15 that did 218 horsepower at 16 PSI.
Okay.
You're using a T25 stock SR turbo. Okay. And now we have the QG18 with a Garrett T28 ball bearing, new brand. Bought from Blue Coral. Now we're doing at low boost 192 horsepower at wastegate pressure, which is 7 psi. And at high boost, we're doing 268 horsepower at 16 psi, creeping to semi horsepower. The tuning was done by R-Tune. It's running on a Itz Zeus Master Classic full standalone management.
Okay.
And bolt-on parts, small bolt-on parts like Turbosmart 38mm wastegate, Greddy blower valve, air motive, fuel pressure regulator, AEM sensors, both fuel and oil for safety wise. You know that's coming handy when you want to jam the engine and want safe fuel just drop on your, it protect your engine. Good thing for the newcomers to know.
We have a tripod boost solenoid, vacuum block, oil catch can, basic. Not no branded thing, but work for the, serve the purpose.
Okay.
And that's basically about it.
Impressive.
Yeah. Oh, the car was tuned on pump gas.
No but issue. Before we go any further, if I didn't say it from the start, I want to say it right now, bro. Your fabrication is on point. Right, the engine bay and everything is on fleek, and it only makes me wonder what's happening on the inside. So let's take a look at the inside of the car. So at the start of the interview, Brandon said welding certificate nothing. I am gonna say power windows nothing. Brandon, tell us a little bit about what's happening inside.
So where we'll start off with is we have three gauges. AEM air fuel, odometer, boost and oil pressure. Right, so apart from performance wise, we have a fully hydro dip interior done by Liquid L Hydrographics, located at Coover. Pick up the little freshener, JDM, courtesy Blue Coral Racing. Yeah, recently bought yesterday at Blue Coral Racing, a brake shifting up together with a, shift boot, right? Excuse me. And that we have original Y11 ZV mats, and that's about it.
Yeah, so Brandon, you pretty much mentioned everything about the interior of the car, but there's one thing that you missed out that I want you to touch on. This flash drive, bro. What's happening here, man?
You see them sod girl on them? They like the little bad tune now. Eh? So you play a little vibe scatting and that bass kicking these little plastic drivers and fall out. Yeah.
So coming to the wheels, we have the XXR 527 supplied by Fitmenjo original, 5 pieces dimension. We have W10 rear disc brakes banjo with a Costco adjustable sway bar, and on the front we have W10 double piston brakes.
So Brandon, I want to say thanks a lot for being a part of Poppy, but your episode was amazing based on all the aspects of the vehicle. Any final words?
I'd like to say thanks to you and the team, Chef Club, Charlie Schultz, Maxxis Center Ltd for having us here, and not to mention the Persad for putting together this bringing car community. Basically, to me, it's bringing car community together because it's a project right on the air. I say thanks to mechanic Charles at the garage. They really helped me out a lot, right? Because I didn't know much. And rather than mechanics, I'll be like the boss here. The little boss ahead, right? Our tune, also we got reliable tune. We got the mechanics, my boss, and the boss one.
Right, one more thing. Certificate nothing, pushman everything.
We would like to acknowledge our sponsors and humbly thank them for their ongoing support. Even during this pandemic, with them we were able to make the Pop the Hood series a reality. Maxxis Tires, PRS Performance, Team World Boss, Tropical Engineering, Trakstar Performance, Monkey Wrench, Shadow Studios, Chalo, David Persad Photography, Itz Zeus Photography, Streetside Productions, Shift Lock,